You worry, you make it double, don't worry. Be happy, don't worry, be happy now.
Hey, how you doing? Good morning. So today I'm doing a video on tenths and hundredths. What is that, right?
Oh, I got it right here.
Tenths, it's like a dime, 0.1, it's 1/10. And we got hundredths. That's 1 out of 100, or 0.01, or it's a penny. Now, what you have to know is all we're doing is we're going down the place value. Now, in the beginning, we did place value, and it was very important. Let me tell you why it's important. So when you have ones, and then what's bigger than ones? Tens. And then what's bigger than ten? Hundredths. And what's bigger than hundredths? Thousand, 10,000, 100,000, a million, 10 million, 100 million. Okay, and so on. So you get bigger and bigger, the number gets more. Now, what if you need something smaller? Let's say you have a dollar. What is smaller than a dollar? Well, easy. 10 cents. Now, you have 10 cents, 20. And what's smaller than 10 cents? A penny. So we're splitting up into smaller, because when you have small, a dollar, you need change to make up that dollar. Now, and is the decimal, okay? Now the name they have now is tenths, hundredths. That represents that it's smaller than ones. Yes, hundredths is not bigger than ones, although you think so, but it's divided. When you go this way, you're dividing. You're getting smaller. So for example, tenths is 10 pennies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right here you have 1 dime, because you have 10 pennies, right? It's 1/10. Look, here's a whole dollar, right? This represents. So each row, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So that's 100. So this is 1/10. Now, when you go to hundredths, it's represented by 0.01, decimal 0.01. Why? Because it's just one little one out of the hundredth. It's 1 penny. How many do you need? You need 100 of those. So that's why it's 1 out of 100. Now, in dimes, you have one whole row. Okay? Have I lost you there yet? So, all right. So let's get down to what we're going to work with. Okay? So, for example, if you have 63, right? 63. What do you have? You can have 6/10 and 3/100, right? Or you can have 63/100, 63 pennies out of 100, okay? Now, when we're doing this, right, you have to remember, keep your hundredths. No, that's 1 penny, 0.01. So if you have 6 hundredths and 6/10, which is greater? Well, 6/10, because this is 6 pennies. This is 6 dimes. That means this equals, I'm going to put it down here, this equals 60 cents, 0.6, right? But
in our book, they won't put the zero because there's no hundredths. Now over here, there's no tenths, and there's six hundredths. You understand? Now, let me get this better. All right. For example, we have 32.32. Now, this represents 3 dimes. So that would be 30 cents. This represents 2 hundredths. So that would be 0.00 dimes and 2 pennies. That is important. So you would write that 0.02. So when you add them up, when you always line up your place value, so you line up your decimals, that's 3 twos. 0.32. All right. Let me see some of the work they got for you over there. Oh, okay. So when you're doing your work, you'll have something like 3.94. How does that look like, right? Well, that's 2 ones, 9 tenths, and 4 hundredths. Yeah. Did I spell that wrong? Hundredths. Okay. So this also you would represent as 3 ones. Yeah. Right? So this would represent by 3 holes, 9 tenths, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 4 hundredths. 1, 2, 3, 4. Notice it's not even 1/10. It's only 4 of those in the 4 pennies out of a dime, right? So I won't even draw it. Just 4 little cubes. All right. Got it? All right. Should I have a music on? Don't worry. Everybody loves my dancing. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Ain't got no place.